Hey guys, I'm Lily Collins.
When you hear the name Lily Collins, you most likely know exactly who we're talking about. But why is it always so hard to pinpoint just what this actress has worked in? Well, it's because we've discovered Lily Collins 100% deserves to be a household name and isn't. However, 2020 may just be her time. It's curious to think not everyone knows who Lily Collins is, considering she's had the most interesting and at times heartbreaking journey into the spotlight. That's why in this video, we're taking you on a journey through Lily's life, from growing up with famous parents, her rendezvous with Zac Efron, and all the twists and turns in between. We're dishing on everything you might have missed over the last two decades. After this, you'll never forget who Lily Collins is again.
I'm a binge watcher. So I'm like, give me the whole show at once and I get to like watch it all. It's great.
Let's take it back to the beginning. The year was 1989, and despite her now having an American accent, Lily was born in the United Kingdom. While she wasn't born directly onto the red carpet, her parents are some pretty influential people. Her mother, Jill Tavelman, is an American actress, and her father, Phil Collins, is a pretty big name in the music industry. He was the drummer and singer of a band called Genesis. Imagine all the cool people Lily got to hang out with throughout the years. Her parents got her right into the family business at just 2 years old. They landed her first role as a guest on the BBC series Growing Pains. While she did spend her childhood years performing at the Youth Academy for Dramatic Arts, Lily originally wanted to take her life in a different direction – journalism. Throughout her teenage years, she made plenty of waves in the media industry. She was a self-starter, and at such a young age, had her own column in the magazine Elle Girl. Her work was also featured in magazines like Seventeen, Teen Vogue, and the Los Angeles Times.
Some things get lost in translation, but just know that I'm finding my way.
People might have questioned her success in journalism and whether her parents' influence had any effect on her making it big, but she definitely proved them all wrong when she landed a spot at one of America's top colleges, the University of Southern California. She even graduated with a degree in broadcast journalism. But while her childhood and teen years may have seemed blissful and happy to the outside world, the truth is Lily struggled majorly throughout her adolescence. Her parents sadly got divorced when she was just 7, and she recently opened up about how that and her father's alcoholism affected her relationship with him. She mentioned that the musician was often absent for long periods of time and says he wasn't the dad I expected. This, as well as her struggle with two grown-up careers, led her to major confidence issues and a struggle with bulimia and anorexia.
As a teenager, I struggled through eating disorders, and so for me, this was a really amazing opportunity to, you know, make everyone feel less alone who's going through it.
She even went as far as describing her adolescent life as out of control. Things got out of control quickly, with even her chances of ever having kids being put at risk. But with Lily being the trooper she is, she worked through her challenges and came out even stronger. It's all documented in her 2017 memoir, Unfiltered. I'm learning how to accept your actions and vocalize how they made me feel. I accept and honor the sadness and anger I felt towards the things you did or didn't do, did or didn't give me, she penned to her father.
Stuff happens along the way, and I really wanted to be a dad.
As you could probably tell by how candid she was about her struggles growing up, Lily is all about creating a safe space for talking about mental illness and other issues that still tend to be a little taboo.
It's a subject matter that is considered far too taboo to talk about, apparently, but it's becoming more and more prevalent within our society.
Her memoir even explains the message behind her trend-setting natural eyebrows. She didn't always love them, and we have her mom to thank for her beautiful brows by encouraging her to be unforgiving when it comes to being yourself.
Can I touch your eyebrow? And it's like the weirdest request.
To prove just how strong this celeb is, it was during these tough times that her transition from journalist to actress really started to take off. She was landing roles in movies like The Blind Side, alongside Sandra Bullock, while treading through some of her darkest days. There's no doubt that Lily is R-E-S-I-L-I-E-N-T. Her emotional role in The Blind Side led to even bigger things. She became the live-action version of Snow White, Mirror Mirror. And we have to say, she does play the perfect princess. From there, she brought the fiery Clary to life in the book-to-movie adaptation The Mortal Instruments City of Bones, and the charming Rosie in Love, Rosie. She even had the opportunity to step into her dark path through her character in the film To the Bone. The film followed a young girl named Ellen, who is currently battling anorexia. It also happened to be the perfect time for Lily to step into the role because it was right before the release of her heartfelt memoir.
We all set out to make a movie to prompt
conversation.
But Lily heartbreakingly admitted that the movie was actually a huge learning opportunity for her because she never had the resources and treatment some do. I just kind of figured it out on my own. We are so glad inspiring celebrities like Lily who share their battles exist.
There used to be this fear of being what I considered overweight. Now, my fear is not living in the moment.
Of course, emerging into Hollywood unfortunately also means having your private life plastered all over the internet and social media. In Lily's case, this led to a lot of speculation when it came to her dating life. Wait until you hear just who Lily has potentially dated. It all started with the one and only Taylor Lautner. After filming their movie Abduction together, the two were together from 2010 to 2011. They even had co-stars gushing about their natural chemistry.
But you gotta admit, it was one pretty exciting first date.
Her next confirmed relationship was also with her co-star and on-screen love interest, Jamie Campbell Bauer. The two worked together on The Mortal Instruments' City of Bones and dated on and off for a whole 6 years. Their adorable Instagram pictures were to die for.
Maybe you should have thought about that before you kissed me.
I kissed you!
These confirmed relationships are just the tip of the iceberg. She's been rumored to have dated big-time celebs like Zac Efron, Chris Evans, and Nick Jonas. Yep, you heard us right, a Jonas brother. But none of these relationships ever took away from the shining star that was and is Lily Collins. It's honestly beyond us at this point how she isn't an Oscar award-winning actress. Who agrees? If you need a little refresher on just some of the films she's worked on in the past couple of years, listen closely. From the Les Miserables BBC miniseries and Stuck in Love to Tolkien and Extremely Wicked, Shockingly Evil and Vile, she may not have an Oscar, but she definitely has versatility. Who else could play the beautiful Fantine and the girlfriend of Ted Bundy all in the same time span of 2 years? Not us.
I've been a huge Tolkien fan since I could remember reading. I've loved fantasy and magic my whole life.
It's not just acting that makes Lily Collins completely underrated. She's also an advocate for important causes in the world. Not only is she a celebrity ambassador for the anti-bullying association Bystander Revolutions, she's also an ambassador for the organization Go Campaign that helps orphans and children in need across the globe. While we may never understand how Lily Collins isn't the millennial Meryl Streep yet, we do know that 2020 is a big year for the star. On October 2nd, she released a new Netflix series, Emily in Paris. Lily plays Emily herself, a young adult traveling across the world for her career while trying to fit into a culture she wasn't raised in.
I am so excited to be here.
Well, that's very unfortunate.
Earlier this year, she also premiered her movie Inheritance that she stars in alongside celebs like Chase Crawford. She plays Lauren, whose father recently passed away. Getting her inheritance turns into a mystery affair that unravels some deep, dark family secrets.
Well, I should know. Maybe I can help.
But it won't be the last time you see Lily's name in shining lights. She's also featured in another upcoming Netflix production, Mank, and has two other projects, The Cradle and Gilded Rage, currently in post-production. Lots more Lily content coming up, guys! She also made some big moves in her personal life. She recently shared on Instagram that she's engaged with her longtime boyfriend and director, Charlie McDowell. All the best to the lovebirds! Despite Lily being part of some huge productions in the last decade, Hollywood has been sleeping on her talent. However, with her name finally getting the attention it deserves, this may finally be her time to break onto the A-list next to some of the entertainment world's biggest names. We're betting Lily will be a household name in no time. How about you? What was the most shocking fact you learned about Lily Collins in this video? Let us know your thoughts on the actress in the comments section below. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next time.